back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to give you a tip on how to improve your arabesques and also what to look out for when you're doing arabesques. So today I've got Sarah with me. Hi Sarah.
Hi.
Thanks for being on my channel. Now, how long have you done for?
Since I was three.
Since you were 3 years old. Okay, where did you train?
I went to White Lodge for
yes.
2 years and I was in Germany.
Yeah.
Yes, at Zebra Over Valley.
Okay, cool.
Yes. Yes, I've been around.
Yes, yes. But she now comes to my classes, which is really nice. It's nice to have her in my classes. And today she's going to be my body to demonstrate it all for you. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Before I go into any more detail, I just wanted to say that this video is filmed in two different locations on the same day. So I was at Dance Works London with Sarah, and now I'm at BBO Dance, where I'll be doing the rest of the video. Now today I am wearing a kind of tomatoey orange bandana. I'm wearing my gilet from Blancmange Ballet and Toning. I'm wearing kind of a posh t-shirt. It's a Gucci t-shirt and it used to be one of my favourite normal day t-shirts, but it's got some holes on the side because I think I got stuck on something. So it's now in my ballet teaching wardrobe. So when I'm feeling posh, that's my go-to t-shirt. I'm wearing my Adidas trousers, and I'm wearing my block teaching shoes as I can point my toes, and it's great. Now, what is an arabesque? An arabesque is an elevated, stretched leg in the direction back or behind you. For example, boom. Now, there's four different arabesques. Let me talk to you to a first arabesque. So your first arabesque, I'll show it really to you, is where the same arm as your supporting leg is in front and the same arm as your working leg is to the sides. Now that's the first arabesque. Now a second arabesque is the same starting position, but that's where the working leg is in front and your supporting leg's arm is to the sides. That's the second arabesque. Now a third position is where your supporting leg arm is high and your working leg arm is low and they are both facing the front. And a lot of female dancers will use this position. Male dancers don't use it that often. And then we have a fourth arabesque, usually shown in a quasi position or across to the audience. And that's where your same arm as your supporting leg is in front and the same arm as your working leg behind you, so there's a nice diagonal line. Now let's go to the section where you can improve your arabesques. Now you need to really know that arabesque is not just about flexibility, because I'm sure you've all seen people with really high arabesques when they are kicking it up in the air. But when it comes to holding the arabesques, that height is a lot lower. So it's about strength and flexibility and putting those two together. Now when you're trying to get height in your arabesque, you need to try to do it in a very safe way. Now if you think about the spine, your spine is made up of many, many, many vertebrae, all the way from the top of your neck down towards your coccyx. So what you want to be careful of is that when you're arching in the back to get that elevation behind you, is not to crunch those vertebrae. So basically what I'm telling you today is to try and keep that length in between the vertebrae while you're going for that height in your arabesques. Now to do this, you need to have a lot of strength in your thoracic spine, which is your upper back. If your thoracic spine is nice and strong, you can take some of that arching out of your lower back and really hold that leg behind you with your upper back. And I'll tell you how to strengthen your thoracic spine now with some floor exercises. What you see a lot of dancers do before a class is the cobra pose. And the cobra pose is where you're lying on your front and you're pushing your back up as high as you can. Now, as you can see in my lower back, there's so much crushing of the vertebrae going on. So that's what not to do. So I'll tell you, give you a few exercises to do which are very strengthening and safe for your lower back. The first exercise I want you to do, so I want you to lie on your front, and from here I want you to really engage your abdominals so that your both hip bones are staying on the floor and you're tightening your abdominals. Now from here, I want you to put your hands underneath your shoulders and with a nice long neck, I want you to push your upper back off the floor and keep your lower back nice and long. And then slowly come back down. And then repeat that again, just the upper back and then lowering back down. Now this exercise is very good and quite simple. So you can do many sets of that before a class. Just get that upper back going to really strengthen up the upper back. Now from here, you can make it a little bit more complicated by starting the same exercise with your arms above your head in fifth position. That's it. Now if you're feeling like you're really strong and that's not quite doing the trick for you, you can make it even harder and put some quarter bras in there. So I'll show you one of those now. And as long as that lower back is nice and long, you can do this over and over again to really strengthen up your back, and I'll promise you, you'll get nice and strong to get those legs that little bit higher. Now a tight hip flexor and a tight psoas can also stop you from getting those legs up. So a good stretch to do before your class, well not before your class, but a good stretch to do when you're nice and warm, and is to take one leg in front, and you can put your foot underneath your knee, place both hands on your knee, and push those hips forwards. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to push your pubic bone down towards your front heel, staying nice and square. And that gives a really nice stretch in that back hip. And then you can relieve that tension slightly by coming back up and then going all the way down. Now next I'm going to give you an exercise which is for those of you who are nice and strong, who are confident that you have the strength and confident that you have that flexibility in your hip. And I'll show that with Sarah at the bar. Now, a portable bar is best for this exercise as you can have your leg in arabesque. But if you have a bar that's attached to the wall, you can do the same exercise in an attitude position. For those of you who are nice and strong, what you can try and do is put your leg on the bar behind you. And as you can see here, Sarah's keeping her lower back nice and long by slightly leaning forwards. Good. So if you can now do a dummy here in your right leg, that's it, and immediately you'll feel that back leg going that little bit higher. And that's exactly correct, keeping that lower back nice and long. And stretch your leg again. That's it. Can you put this hand across your chest on your right shoulder? That's it, good. Because I just want the viewers at home to see how long your lower back is. So do that here one more time. That's it. And as you can see, that lower back is still nice and lengthened, so it's very safe to do this practice. Good. Stretch that up. Now, can you do it wrong? Can you really arch in that lower back and then do the plie? That's it. So that's what you do not want to do, because that's really damaging for your vertebrae in that lower spine. Good. So stretch that up. Let's do one more of the good one. That's it. So nice deep plie. Keep that lower spine nice and long. See how high you can go. And there you want to hold it for a good 6 seconds. And what that does is it really stretches out that left hip or that hip of your arabesque leg, and it gives you that nice length and the ability to lift your leg high. Thank you.
Now another thing to be mindful of is when you look at someone doing arabesque from the front is that both shoulders and hips stay facing the front when nice and square. So that was the correct version. And now you'll see Sarah opening her left shoulder and her left hip too much open to the center, and we've lost that squareness, so I hope you can see that well here. Now to finish off, I wanted Sarah to do a beautiful arabesque with a nice long lower back, and it's very safe for the body.
Hope you enjoyed this video on arabesque. So don't forget, arabesque consists of two main things. One is flexibility, second one is the strength. Yes, and you want to be very careful that you're not crushing your vertebrae, especially in that lower back. So when a teacher says your back should be completely straight and your leg at a 90 degree angle. That's not always achievable. I would much rather say, have your shoulders in front of your hips to be able to get that leg up in a safe way. So let me know if you like this. Don't forget to subscribe and let me know what you want to see next. Bye for now.